Good morning and welcome to the channel. In the previous episode, I was working with DC to DC converter, and some of you who seen the video saw that I damaged the cable. And I realized that might have been a blessing because it forced me to do a bit more research and try to understand how DC to DC converter works. So let me share with you what I found. On the open inverter board, next to the Atmega chip, we have a JST connector, and the cable from the JST connector goes to DC to DC converter. Now we can see the same connector on the schematic. The first signal is NODD. NODD is actually an indication if DC to DC converter is running. If we have 5 to 7 volts, that means that DC to DC converter is functioning correctly. And if we have 2 to 4, then there is a fault. The next signal is VLO. VLO is actually the signal we can use to control the output of DC to DC converter. So if we supply PWM signal to this part of the connector, we then control the level of the voltage from DC to DC converter. AGCT is effectively a signal to turn on off the DC to DC converter. So if we have 12 volts on it, it will enable the DC to DC converter. So as you can see on the jumper here, we're effectively putting 12 volts in to this IGCT signal. And the last one, the sense signal, it to sense the presence of the 12 volts battery. On the open inverter board, effectively this signal is connected to the 12 volts in. Now we're looking at the back of the inverter, at the DC to DC converter side of things. As we've said before, this is where the high voltage enters the DC to DC converter. On the Toyota normal setup, we would come in from here through these two connectors and we go into the buck boost converter. So in our case, we are not going to go through buck boost. We're just going to go there. I had a desire to use this connector because it's an IEM quality connector to connect the high voltage. And basically that's how Toyota connects the high voltage. Right, so if we now look from the capacitor point of view, that's where the high voltage comes in. It goes through these two bus bars. This one goes here and comes to this bus bar, and this one comes to this one. We come in to this and this connection in here. Now if we can look outside from the cover of the door of the inverter, that's where the negative and positive comes in from the high voltage battery. And as you can see here, so these two are exactly those two. So if we now put the cover on, so effectively it will come in through here and through here. But we want it to be connected at this connector and this connector. So our connections from the DC to DC converter is actually here and in here. So what we can do is have this link to enable DC to DC converter. It will allow us to kill two birds with one stone. So it will allow me to enable the connection through the Toyota terminal, which is on here. But at the same time, it will allow me to enable DC to DC converter. My plan was to solder in my test cables to the high voltage connector. So I began from clearing the isolation from the high voltage connector on the Toyota side of the inverter. And I was trying to solder in my test cables, only to find out that actually it was not possible to solder this part of the cable. So I had to give up on that idea. Instead, I decided to just connect my test cables for now directly to the inverter. First, I needed to connect a DC link on the open inverter board to enable DC to DC converter. After that, I proceeded with the connection of the another link cable, which this time will connect the input from the battery into the inverter input. At the same time, it will feed in the high voltage into the DC to DC converter. Next was the turn of HV connection from the battery side. And this time I've just plugged in the wires that coming from my test power supply, which deliver 60 volts to the inverter. Now I'm testing the connection from this side here. And we have our joint link on the other side. So this is the 12 volt supply to to the inverter where it's on. Now the pre-charge is on. Now we start the main contactor, pre-charge is off. Now trying to do the throttle. And it's working. And now we have a motor view. Now I'm trying to test the DC to DC converter, and to fire up the DC to DC converter I will need to have some sort of a load connected. So I've decided to use my lithium-ion battery made of 18650 cells to try to see whether it will work or not. I almost expect it not to work because I only have 60 volts and I believe that converter will work only, it will work only from 100 volts. So, but I thought I'd give it a try, see if it will make a difference or not. It's not hard to do a little test. So I'm just connecting the minus of the battery to the ground, to the basically body of the inverter, and the plus is connected over here. If it works, I should have about 14 volts on here. Right, I started the inverter and I connected the DVM, and now we still have 8.14, which means the DC to DC converter is not working. Okay, so yeah, we'll need to try. I really need to get 100 volts or more on it and then test.